When patients have benign disease of the thyroid gland, such as benign symptomatic goiters or toxic adenomas, those that produce too much hormone, we have traditionally offered surgical resection. Even if it's a single nodule that is causing the problem, most of the time the patients would require removal of at least half of the thyroid gland that contains the nodule for treatment. This is a good operation. A thyroid lobectomy is an outpatient procedure. It is associated with low complications, and generally patients do very, very well after the operation. However, even with removal of just half of the thyroid gland, a minimum of 25% of patients will require some thyroid hormone supplementation at some point in their lifetime. Interventional endocrinology has the potential to revolutionize the way we manage these diseases. It is an emerging field where we're using non-surgical interventions to address disorders of the endocrine system that we would normally treat with surgery. One of these interventions is radiofrequency ablation, otherwise known as RFA. With ultrasound-guided RFA, we're using the ultrasound to guide placement of an electrode into thyroid nodules. The electrode itself has an active tip that emits radiofrequency waves that allows us to burn the tissue surrounding that tip in a very targeted, precise manner. At Columbia, we perform this procedure in our ambulatory thyroid center, and patients are able to avoid general anesthesia and surgery.
Although thyroid lobectomy remains the standard of care for the treatment of these diseases,
for those patients who really want to avoid the risk of thyroid hormone dependency after their operation, radiofrequency ablation provides a good alternative treatment. With RFA, the risk for needing thyroid hormone after the procedure is almost zero. This is because RFA allows us to target just the thyroid nodule and not any of the healthy thyroid tissue surrounding it. At the end of the day, with a good ablation using the right techniques, we can achieve an average of 80 to 90% volume reduction without the need for surgery and without the need for hormone dependency in the future. In terms of follow-up, we use ultrasound to look at objective measures such as changes in the diameter and volume of the thyroid nodules, and we look for resolution of the patient's symptoms. Radiofrequency ablation is not a good procedure for everyone. The electrode does have an electric current running through it, and therefore patients with cardiac arrhythmias or those that may be pregnant are not good candidates for this procedure. For those patients with symptomatic goiters or toxic adenomas who really do want to try to avoid surgery and the potential need for thyroid hormone in the future, they should inquire with their physician whether radiofrequency ablation would be a good option for them.